This is the technical difficulties. We're playing Citation Needed. Joining me today, he reads books, you know, it's Chris Joel.
No letters once more.
The bounties man on the internet, Matt Gray.
Hello.
And everybody's favourite, Gary Brannan. Gary Brannan.
Accompany me into the inner reaches of Dale Winton.
In front of me, I've got an article from Wikipedia and these folks can't see it. Every fact they get right, it's a point of a ding and the special prize for taking the good answer, which is...
Mystery Biscuits!
Oh, yeah. Personal best there. Today, we are talking about the Jimmy Carter rabbit incident.
Oh, brilliant. Oh. Giant swimming rabbit attacks Jimmy Carter whilst fishing.
Mystery Biscuits!
We can go out.
Personal bet, right. See everybody. That's us done for the day.
Were you both going for that? Did you beat Gary to that?
Yeah. It was one of my few sort of extra super special bits of weird general knowledge, and I knew Brannan would know it as well.
You know what? I didn't actually, so well played.
Right. I genuinely thought you'd beaten him to the punch there.
Well,
I was going to make up some shtick, but the point is, what I was going to make up weren't too far from the truth, that is.
I mean, obviously you've won, but...
obviously, this show is now entirely redundant for you, the viewer. I mean, this is the way we should have done them all along.
Let's explore this, because there's quite a lot to go on here. What do you know about this?
Ostensibly, an enormous rodent swimming across a lake to Jimmy Carter, who's fishing in this little sort of boat about the size of our table. Yeah,
US President Jimmy Carter.
Yeah. He's up at whatever the country retreat is. And this thing just sort of gets up on the back end of the boat. And he's wailing on it with the oar.
It was a swamp rabbit, a swamp hare.
Of course. Yeah. Only in America would they call it a swamp rabbit. Give it the real dangerous edge it obviously
it's
needs.
It's a large cottontail rabbit. It's a big thing.
Looks about like that.
Essentially, it's still a rabbit though, yeah?
That can swim.
But it's got big, nasty, pointy teeth. And it can jump over about.
All right, it can swim, that's one thing. If it had its own kayak, I'd be more worried. Let's face it.
No, it's much harder to get out of the kayak into another boat. The rabbit can use a kayak, but it's on attack mode, you know.
So it got amphibious rabbit attack as well.
Yeah.
I can imagine it just whittling away.
It only didn't use its torpedoes because, you know, there's only one of him. I can take him hand to hand.
Sorry.
And it would get launched backwards.
In the middle of this lake, a log-made submarine just pokes the conning tower above the surface. The
exactly.
Top unscrews, donk, out comes a rabbit in a naval uniform. Fire! Sir, it's ungentlemanly to torpedo our president without giving him prior warning.
I'll take it myself then.
I mean, that was the problem. The
dagger
problem
in his mouth.
What was a fairly mundane story is really funny when you start ripping on it. And everyone did.
This is very funny anyway, because let's face it, it's a president being attacked by a great rabbit. I mean, that's great. Can you imagine just translating it here? Gordon Brown is out one day, I don't know, cycling along the roads. A sheep gets out and wails the out of him. I'm sorry, I'd watch that day and night.
What was the president's side of the story here?
The left-hand side.
He was out there fishing in a peaceful fashion. Maybe those things he did against the rabbits in his time in office came back to bite him on the ass. Quite literally.
No, he said the rabbit had good reason for being in a panic and jumping away.
Was it being chased by a crocodile?
It's being chased by something.
FBI agents there to escort the president.
A court order.
Hounds. But I'm going to give you a point of being chased there.
Okay. So the rabbit's been hunted and is running away.
Yep. And he said, swam toward my boat. When he almost got there, I splashed some water with a paddle. That is Jimmy Carter's side of the story.
I was going to say, that sounds very much like one side of a story in any incident. So I'm innocently on the water. I just splashed me paddle. Next thing I know, he's on me. Turns out he called his mother or something while it were coming over.
What did Carter's staff say about this when he got back to his office?
The staff is in the oar.
No.
Ha 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 ha, boss, you got your ass kicked by a rabbit.
No.
Nothing. They were mute.
Because they too were rabbits. Tinfoil hat.
Yeah, giant rabbit conspiracies trying to take over the giant lizard government of the world.
Exactly. Inside job, man. Inside job.
No, what?
Rabbits can't cut through steel beams.
Rabbits can't what?
Cut through steel beams. Swim.
Thank you. Have a point. They insisted rabbits couldn't swim.
Well, I think they just got a call bull on that one.
Yeah, well, no one believed him apart from then the incident was captured.
So they're literally his video.
Puts on tinfoil hat. How convenient. There just happened to be a camera there when the rabbit attacked the president. False flag, people. False flag.
There was a second rabbit behind the grassy knoll.
Firing his torpedo.
Yes. There was a second rabbit in the submarine. You can only just make out the picture because they haven't got a very good steady cam.
When you say footage, it is just a photo. But
hang on a sec.
Oh, I thought it was... Oh.
Rewind.
A grassy knoll is a small little hill, is it not?
It is.
What would live inside a small little hill?
Teletubbies.
Yeah, Teletubbies killed Kennedy. That's where I was going with this. Yeah.
Nunu is about to be very naughty.
I've got the thought of like the Lee Harvey Oswald footage being recut now for Tinky Winky being pulled out as Poe jumps out.
This president is Tubby Toast.
Meanwhile, the rabbits who are behind all this are still on the grassy knoll. Excellent, they cried.
Theme from Watership Down plays the end.
Yep.
But in a minor key, just to make it a little bit more evil.
More evil than Watership Down.
Yeah.
obviously, the president did not mention this to reporters because I got chased by a rabbit and had to splash it away is not a good PR story. How did it leak?
Rabbits did it.
Conspiracy. It's a rabbit.
Well, how did the boat leak? I think a rabbit took a big frigging chunk out of it by the sound of it.
Well, if someone photographed it... Sorry.
No, White House press photographer, official, so it wouldn't have got out without...
When they got it developed, the developer... Saw it.
No, so it's the press secretary just kind of told a reporter about it
because it is quite funny.
It is quite funny, and the reporter promptly filed it with the wire service. And the story, president attacked by rabbits, promptly appeared on the Washington Post.
I can absolutely see David Cameron getting.
Yeah. The thing is, they hadn't released the photo because they didn't want the photo of the president hitting a rabbit. So what was on the front of the Washington Post?
A cartoon, an artist's impression.
Yes, you're getting a point straight away, but bear in mind, this is 1979.
Oh, I thought it was earlier than that.
What would have happened in 1979? What pop culture thing would they have used for President Attacked by Rabbit?
Disco or something like that.
79.
It's a film.
Star Wars?
No.
No, that's 77.
77, 81.
About attacks from the water.
Close Encounters of the Third Kind.
Oh, that's a...
Mystery Biscuits!
Oh, yeah.
It's wrong.
Nose.
Jaws. I'll give you the point there. It was Paws.
Oh.
But it was the Jaws poster with a rabbit instead.
Fair enough, Ski.
The White House didn't release the photo until, I quote here, it turned up during the Reagan administration.
Oh, baby. Filed under rabbits, lol, in a filing cabinet.
Reagan quickly used it as propaganda to go and invade the rabbit nation.
Yes, obviously.
Mr. Rabbit, turn this Warren down.
It played into this idea that Carter's presidency was hapless, was feeble, was someone who could be taken down by a rabbit. But it's not the only article here listed under Jimmy Carter... incident. So fill in the blank. What's the other weird thing that happened to Jimmy Carter during his presidency? Well, it didn't come out until his presidency. It actually happened in 1969.
Was it food? Was it a sandwich incident?
No. No, you might be thinking of George H.W. Bush throwing up in the Japanese Prime Minister's lap. That was something that happened. He was governor of Georgia in 1969.
Oh, it's a funny thing, though.
Oh, no, I wouldn't go with funny. I'd go with spooky.
Ghost. Witch.
Sasquatch.
UFO.
Oh, baby. Brilliant.
The Jimmy Carter UFO incident sits quite nicely next to the Jimmy Carter rabbit incident.
And the two aren't linked. Tinfoil hat.
Apparently not. Jimmy Carter saw an object that was bright white, about as bright as the moon, and 30 degrees above the horizon.
Was it the moon?
Was it the moon?
Now, you say that...
It was as big as the moon, where the moon should be, and it looked a little bit like the moon.
But it was in the way of the moon. I couldn't see the moon.
I couldn't see the moon for the big white moon thing in front of the moon.
Well, apparently it changed colour to blue, then red, then white.
The reflection of America in the sky.
Did you just hit yourself really hard there?
Really quite hard.
No, quite hard.
It's not like it hurt. Yeah.
About 20 people unable to work out what a mysterious light could be.
Crash zoom. Rabbit.
With a red torch. Yeah.
Going,
they were <I'm> up.
What is the most likely explanation? What do you see near the horizon that's frequently mistaken for a UFO?
Venus.
Point. Absolutely right. Jimmy Carter said he did not believe the object was Venus.
Well, I think it was his plane or something. I wasn't president by this point.
He thought...
You're late!
Yeah.
He thought it might be a helicopter or something like that.
With a rabbit in it.
But what did he say during his election campaign? What did he tell reporters? What would he do?
If I find out I was probed by aliens, I'll let you know.
That's technically true. If I become president, I'll make every piece of information this country has about UFO sightings available to the public.
Did he?
Ooh. Well, there weren't any.
No.
Which does beg a question.
Definitely not.
Yes, if you were in on the conspiracy and a president coming in said, I'm going to make this conspiracy public, would you let them in on the conspiracy?
Or would you show them the empty filing cabinet that says evidence for UFOs, hastily written on the front, and before that said, evidence for rabbit conspiracy?
What did he say was the reason that he wasn't actually going to make every one of the UFO files?
Truth?
Open?
You can handle the truth.
You know what? I'm going to give you the point. Defense implications. See, last one's fill in the blanks here. The George H.W. Bush blank incident.
Sandwich.
Vomiting, but yes, I'll give you that. It was at a formal dinner. The Bill Clinton blank controversy.
Monica Lewinsky.
No, haircut.
What?
Oh, come on, we've gone from man attacked by rabbit to man spews on diplomat to man has trim.
Man has trim while in Air Force One and grounding other planes, allegedly. the Dick Cheney blank incident.
Oh, ditching people.
Quail.
Hunting, yes. You can all have a point for that one.
Yay!
And finally...
I've got a point for saying Dick Cheney dick incident.
may not have been paying attention there.
Technically, he's right because Dick Cheney was involved in this.
Yes.
I thought you were going to say Dick Cheney wasn't it?
Also, opinion. Also true. Opinion. Yeah. And finally, the blank of Keir Bannog.
Rabbit.
Point. Absolutely right. It's the one from Monty Python and the Holy Grail, and it's listed as a related article.
Yes.
Chris, obviously, you win this week's show. Because you knew about it and gave everyone just the answers. So congratulations to you. You win permission to dress up as a famous frog and go hide in a cave. It's a hermit Kermit permit. So do enjoy that.
Let's get out of here.
Yay!
You are dressed appropriately. So with that, we say thank you to Chris Joel, Matt Gray, Gary Brannan. I've been Tom Scott. That has been this run of Citation Needed. Thank you very much. We will see you next time.
Self-service machines, it said, and how's this for a sign from the future? Does not accept euros or polymer notes. Ooh. If he didn't win a sporting event or invent some kind of metalworking process, then quite frankly, I'm out of here.
Right, I lost two things narrowed.
Thank you for watching Citation Needed. You've reached the end of this series.
Thank you very much for watching. We have two other series on YouTube if you haven't seen them yet, and a load of old audio episodes on techdiff.co.uk.
We will be making some more in the future.
At some point. We're not quite sure when. It's quite difficult to get all the four of us together in one studio.
But it should happen at some point.
In the meantime, we'll see you on the internet.
Bye.
Bye.